This next question comes from a much older video, getting started with 6-layer boards. What about 8 layers? Is it good to put signal, ground, 3.3 volts, ground, signal, signal, and then some traces with 5 and 10 volts going on an 8-layer board? Now, this is a really good question because typically when you go to something like an 8-layer board, you're doing it because you have so many signals on that board that you just can't fit them into a lower layer count. Thus, you need the additional signal layer and probably another ground layer in order to define impedance and shield traces on different layers. So of course, the outer two layers on the bottom, signal and signal, being adjacent to each other is not a good idea in this instance. What you could do in this example is put one of those signal layers next to that 3.3 volt layer. And the reason you could do that is because it ensures the outer layer with signals has a ground plane right next to it. Now, by putting those signal layers on that inner layer, for example, layer 4, that's going to ensure that you have a path for lower speed signals that could be routed over a power plane without having to worry about the capacitive coupling between power and ground. Now, another thing you could do with that power plane is, of course, you could also put those 5 volt and 10 volt voltage rails into that power layer. So you could have one dedicated power layer with all of your rails. So we have a project that we're doing on the Ultim Academy channel with an Ethernet switch that uses multiple voltage rails, and we're gonna do a review of that project coming up very soon. We're just waiting for the board to get out of assembly. Make sure to go subscribe to Ultim Academy and you'll be notified when that video comes out.